Welcome to Out of the Archive, the Class 37s. In this programme, we use early video material and take a look at the class at work on passenger and freight across the country from Cornwall to Scotland during the 1980s and early 1990s. And what better way to begin with a 37 in its original styling with large round buffers and full front end skirting. Number 37105 drifts through Manningtree on 21st of February 1986. Carlisle is another place where Class 37 activity has always been part of the railway scene. In the early 1980s, it was Scottish examples that were the most common. There is one part of the country that is synonymous with the 37s, and this is Wales. In particular, the South Wales coal mining areas were a haven for the class ever since D6742 and 6743 were sent there on trials in September 1962. Since their introduction to the duchy in the late 1970s, Cornwall has been a regular stamping ground for the 37s when they were first introduced to replace the Class 25s on clay trains. The northeast was home to the 37s from New, soon after the first 30 went to the Anglia region. Hull dairy coats obtained 11 from October 1961, and they have been part of the railway scene in this region ever since. Scotland received their first examples of the class back in late 1966, when a major reshuffle between Western Region and North Eastern Region locomotives saw Eastfield, Polmody and Haymarket receive allocations. They were to become the mainstay of the Scottish freight and passenger scene in the mid to late 1980s. The main line from Birmingham to Chesterfield was common ground for the class, where they worked a large proportion of freight services seen along the route. Some of the most popular workings for the class was their use on stone trains around the Buxton quarries in Derbyshire. They became particularly common in the late 1980s and early 1990s, and it is during this period that we pay a visit to the area as we conclude part one of Out of the Archive, the Class 37s.